One of the things that Dr. Chris Nichols says is that carbon is the energy currency of the soil that feeds all of those soil microbes. Remember, you might have 1 to 2 tons of soil microbes in the soil. So how do you get the carbon into the ground to feed the microbes? Well, that's where a live root in the soil as many days of the year as possible comes in. Plants are the miracle workers that use the sun's energy to convert carbon dioxide into carbohydrates. A sizable proportion of the carbohydrates travel down through the roots and into the soil to feed the soil in the zone that we call the rhizosphere, about 2 or 3 millimeters around the roots. This rhizosphere is absolutely teeming with life, soil microbes, soil microarthropods, all sorts of things. And we can compare the rhizosphere to a city and the bulk soil, which has 2 or 3 orders of magnitude less life in it, as a microbial desert. So there's a huge contrast between bulk soil and then the rhizosphere itself. So why do plants pump all of this energy into the ground? I can assure you, it's not charity, it's symbiosis. Plants supply soil microbes with energy in the form of carbohydrates. And in return, these microbes supply the plants with additional water, with nutrients, and even help to protect the plant's health. In this sense, we can boil it down to saying, plants feed the soil so that soil can feed the plants. Think about that for a little while. If we put it in another way, the plants and the soils are one. In agroecosystems, how do we feed the soil? Well, in my own garden, my vegetable or cash crop supplies quite a lot of the carbon or feeds the soil in the growing season. But in the off season, I really like to plant cover crops. Eric and Robbie also use cover crops. In the cool season, they might use rye or clover. And in the warm season, they like to use things like sorghum, Sudan, and sun hemp, which happens to be a prolific nitrogen fixer. Jason plants cool season cover crops after his corn and soybean rotation. In South Carolina, this gives it plenty of time to grow, and he typically has about 10,000 pounds per acre of cover crop that covers the soil. Another row crop farmer, Carl Coleman, likes to plant a warm season cover crop of sorghum, Sudan, sun hemp, maybe sunflowers, and then also cowpeas and radish. In the 2-month window before he plants his wheat, he can grow up to 8,000 pounds per acre of biomass with all of the heat units that remain in the season. So this is a huge benefit to him. So how have we seen the benefits from keeping a live root in the soil as many days of the year as possible? First, we see a lot more soil life. We see better soil organic matter. We see more roots in the ground. We see better infiltration and better soil structure as well. We've seen a measurable reduction in soil compaction. And in fact, the 5 farmers that I work with in the coastal plain have actually parked their subsoilers. This is a hugely energy intensive operation. Believe me, the action of parking a subsoiler in a place like the coastal plain of South Carolina is considered a radical move. But then keeping a live root in the soil year round is a radical idea.